Okay, I think we can start now. So hello and welcome to our learning sneak preview live session, introducing the learning journey, create processes and automations with SAP Build Process Automation. I'm Philip and I'm here for the technical moderation today. So let's start with the technical part. As you already noticed, you cannot turn on your webcams or unmute yourself because we are in the webinar Zoom mode today. But don't worry, in the Q&A tab down below, you will be able to ask some questions and we will answer them in the end of the session. Likewise, this live session will also be recorded, but the Q&A part at the end will not be part of the recording. So don't hesitate to ask any questions you like. Another point that I would like to mention is that you will find on learningsap.com under the learning journey, some Q&A and deep dive live sessions. So with the Q&A live sessions, you can gain answers to questions arising from your self-study. And expert deep dive live sessions fill knowledge gaps on specific topics which are difficult to grasp or additional topics that are not included in the learning journeys. So that was it from my side. And now I will give the word to our expert Zamir.
Many thanks, Hilly. I introduce myself first. I am Samir Hamishi. I am working on Platinum in Platinum engineering team in the project SAP Build Process Automation. So I am mainly in charge of the enablement and the content that we need for learning and enable our customers. So today I will talk about the learning journey of our product and how to create processes and automations. Let me share my screen and guide you through this journey. I hope you see my screen, yeah?
Yes, we can see it.
Yeah, okay. So the journey starts from the learning.sap.com, as Philip said. Here you can browse all the content or the learning journeys that you want. If you search for build, you will find our product or our learning journey is part of other learning journeys. Among them, build SAP Build Work Zone and also SAP Build Apps. They are part of the BTP offering called SAP Build. So today I will guide you on the first one, which is, or on this one, which is the creation of processes and automation. Inside, you will find an introduction by my colleague, Shadrin Mikael. So he is an SME from the learning team. And also inside, you will find all the content. It's made of six units in all. So the first part is an introduction to the product. It explains the path to the SAP Build Process Automation. So this, the product came from two standalone products from SAP. The first one is workflow management, and the second one is the SAP Intelligent RPA, or Robotic Process Automation. So here you find a way how to evaluate the solution and also to get into the product. Mainly, if we go to the learning, you can select to start the learning and you get into the first unit, which explains to you the path to SAP Build Process Automation. This explains exactly a way or a path for all our customers. Customers coming with already projects with SAP workflow management. Other customers could come also with SAP Intelligent Robotic Process Automation. Some of them could come with both of them, and others are just new customers to go into the product. So no worries, you will find all the information that you need. And here you will find mainly explanation why we need the BPMs, or what we call BPM systems. They are business process management softwares. So you will find a deep explanation in 40 minutes and then go through reviewing at least the roles involved in business processes and evaluating also different working modes in SAP Build Process Automation. At the end, you get a quiz at the end of each unit. Of course, you get the quiz. And then you go into interesting, let's say, units where you can exercise also by yourself the projects. And also, if you don't create them from scratch, don't worry, you will find also existing content that you can use straight away. So you can import from the store, make some configurations maybe if they are needed, and also edit them and also update, adding, for example, if we take an RPA or let's say a sample that is related to RPA, you can save it as and add more artifacts in it and then release it and deploy it again. So you will see all these steps inside the exercises. So coming into the starting point, you will find a full use case handled in the several units. You will start building your process related to sales orders approval. So you create the process with forms, form approvals, notification forms, and then configure it at the beginning. Then you will enhance it using automations. So here I will maybe go into this unit where you can find why we need RPA in processes, what are the business values of the automations inside, but also evaluating the use cases, which kind of use cases you can use in your, let's say, in your company if you need to reduce, let's say, the time of the processes and so on. Some of the units, as I told you, have some videos, so explanations and animations, but also some videos with the experts. From my side, I participated in this unit. We have also additional units like decisions where you find my colleague Arshana doing some explanations, but also in the exercises like the boosting sales order. If I click on it, you will see that there are some explanation about the use case here. I did it myself. I will not go through the video, but also inside exercises, how to do your exercise in your live system, if you have it as a customer, but also you could do it in a free tier landscape. You can set it up and do it or try an account. It's also possible. All these are possible, but all, here you will find at least a simulation where you click on the exercise and then you will be guided through the tutorial. So you will have this experience by starting the tutorial. You will get really feeling like you are doing the exercise at the same time you are guided in the exercise. Here, for example, I will open an exercise that is created in the previous unit, and then you will be guided how to enhance your process, this one that was created in the previous section, with the forms, as I told you. Here it's an approval form, notification forms, starting form, and then you start enhancing it with a new automation, and so on. So I will not go deep into all the actions here, but I gave you just the idea. And all what you do in the exercise, it's strongly recommended to perform the steps in the live environment. Of course, you will have really good learning experience in real systems rather than doing the simulations. But if you don't have it straight away, or you prefer go through the learning first and then apply it later, you can go through the simulation, or you will find also through the screenshots. If you are, maybe it's too much to follow all the steps in the simulation, you can do it by your pace here, following exactly the same screenshots, the same actions described in the simulation. And you will find for all the remaining units where we have exercises here, for example, you will prepare the desktop agents, the agent. Once you've done with your automation, you should prepare the runtime for your use case. So you have to prepare the desktop agent, and you go through the steps in order to install it and to make your project working. Again, after adding an automation here, you reduce some of the actions that were requested in the beginning. In the beginning of the scenario, you are asked to create a form with several entries. So we have more or less, I think, 7 or 8 entries into the form. So if the user start doing entering the orders, entering 7 entries in one form several times, it's tedious, first of all, but also it's prone to errors and so on. So that's why we added the automation here, to reduce the actions of the user. The user has to give only the order and maybe also the name of the customer, and then all the relevant information will be retrieved by the automation. That's exactly why we use automations. It's to alleviate a little bit the hard work of the users. And once we've done with that, we have another challenge with the approval. Here, we have an approval form. And in the first setting of this project, we put it for only one person. So one approver, we set it, and then it's always the same person or a group of persons that are approving the order. But the challenge that we have, for example, to make here, to make it like a complex decision, so calculated, to route the approvers to the right team. For example, it's if the order, sales order is above a certain amount, we give it to certain team. But if we have a higher level of approval, we could also route it to higher managers or higher people to approve it. And this is done in the advanced process building here. You will find insight how to improve your sales order management process with decision logic. And I encourage you to go to the deep dive sessions that Philip mentioned in the beginning. We have coming sessions that you can attend, but also we have the recordings of the previous sessions. You will find really a good introduction by Mikael. He introduced the how to create this first process. It's not the same use case like here, but it's very similar. But you will go deep into learning how you implement your decisions and the explanations of the decisions and the way how he designed the process. So you will find also here additional learnings about the visibility scenario, but also how we go through the APIs, how we use APIs, how we leverage APIs in SAP Build Process Automation. So mainly you will go through the creation of action using the specification, the right specification, but also how to consume it inside your process, how to use it inside your process. And also you will have, in a more general way, leveraging the SAP Process Automation's API. This is the last unit where you can find additional learnings about it. And this is the end of our journey right now. So going back to the learning journey itself, so if I go in the learning journey, you will find here live sessions that I told you from the expert deep dive lessons, the ones that are in the calendar right now. You will find how to create and configure decision logic in your process. And the next one is on 27th of September, if you can. And you see, we have different time zone. You can register according to the one that you want. But if you want to have a flavor of the current or the executed ones, you can go also to the recording and search for the ones regarding this topic. So maybe in the future, you will expect having a live system, access to a live system. We are preparing that with the IT. It's not yet available, but it will be very soon. And also, you can expect some changes in the learning journey after TechEd, because we have new features coming into the product, and also we want to enhance it with all these changes. I hope you will get tuned to TechEd, first of all, because there will be a lot of announcement about the new features, but also get additional learnings, because also the learning team is working hard to make it a better experience from the learning perspective for everyone. And I think from my side, that's it. If you want, Philip, I can hand it to you now.
Yes, perfect. Thank you. Thank you all for your attention, and thank you, Zamir, for this excellent presentation and the sneak preview session. I will end now the recording